Tyrese Haliburton is out there with White. Then it's Smith. Then it's Karl Anthony Towns. And it's Dozier in at the three spot. The last game of the season is always surrounded with a lot of hope. Playoff hopes for most teams. And Greg, hopes for the future for the others.
In one way or another, every player is happy to reach this point. Either so they can finally get their playoff run started, or so they can get their well-deserved rest in the offseason.
Now here's Murray. James, left side. And it's good for two.
The guy's just a superior strength by James. Even when the defense roughs him up, he's more than capable of playing through them. It's amazing.
2022, Greg, a year for the Washington Wizards with some historic significance.
And it marks 25 years of the Washington Wizards' name being on an NBA jersey. A cool moment for the current players who can look back on this franchise and know they're a part of history.
And so it's Haliburton who brings up the ball for the Wizards. It's a three-point game.
But Haliburton can be so clever with the basketball. Helps yet another teammate take advantage of an opening.
Now here's Murray. James in the post. And they pick up two.
Well, hit a man in stride. That is a textbook delivery.
Last outing for Houston, it was a loss to Charlotte. And at the top of the key, Towns, 6 feet out. The Rockets pull it in. Last time they met in Houston.
Yeah, and they won that matchup last time. And it wasn't even close, guys.
Yeah, I thought that had to do with getting the starters in foul trouble and then taking advantage of the substitutes. And that led to a huge disparity on the scoreboard.
So it's the Wizards now following the score by Houston. White, wide open. He fires. And the three off target. And the latest now from our sideline reporter, David Aldridge. David, it's all yours. Take it away.
Hey, Kevin, I caught up with Washington's head coach and told me we have to play really good interior defense. We know they want to get to the rim. We know that's the game plan. So we've got some tactics to keep them from doing so. Guys, we will see what they came up with in the lab.
Thank you, David.
Boy, the offensive flow just isn't there right now. One for five to start the game. That's already this guy's second foul now. He's either going to have to sit or play a bit more conservatively.
And Washington making a change here. Crowder's checked in.
Jay Crowder.
Now about 2 minutes gone here in the first quarter. Alvarado passes to Murray. James outside. Offensive rebound. Ayton. And Ayton throws it down.
Well, you have to love DeAndre Ayton's effort, intensity, and relentlessness as a rebounder.
Outside, White. Towns kicks to Crowder. Will it go? And he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, LeBron, but he's got the chance James to pick up the points at the line. That's on
foul.
LeBron James.
First
wow,
team
wow, he got whacked on that one.
At
shouldn't be much
debate Washington
there.
And a chance to catch up on some numbers here. Scoring breakdown for the Rockets.
Two shots.
I like how they've worked the ball inside, getting looks closer in there, and that really helps your offense.
And the other thing I love, how they're making the extra pass. They're not settling for the first shot. They're going from good to great.
Rockets leading by eight. And it's Murray. That time on the assist by James. 6 points for Jamal Murray.
The ball movement on this run has been fantastic and is a big part of why they've been able to get these good looks.
And you love seeing that great Mobile One drive a second time.
And continuing to press their advantage. They're not taking their foot off the gas.
I think the handles of Jay Crowder may catch some people off guard. This guy's a capable ball handler when given space.
James has a two-pointer. Tappan kicks to James. Murray dishes to LeBron. Rebound by Smith.
And this quarter, he has clearly been off the mark.
Pass to Crowder. And he could not get that one to go. A lot of contact, and he'll go to the line for two.
I think you have to be cautious with guarding Jay Crowder. He excels at using his body to get these calls.
And this is his second trip to the line in the game.
And the free throws have been dropping for him at a rate of about 77% on the season.
And the first one at the line is good. And both free throws good from Crowder.
I just have so much respect for how Jay Crowder plays the game. This guy works so hard for every single minute he's out there, and you love seeing that.
Here's Alvarado. Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him.
And although an undersized center, Moore been making up for it with some serious hops.
Now here's White. 8-point game. James looking it over. And Ayton throws it down.
And what a way to start this game, dominating at both ends of the floor.
And give them credit for approaching this game with the right energy and intensity. This team has attacked every chance they've gotten.
Here's White following the score by Houston. Can't hit that one. James with some nice D.
Credit the defense right there. They have not allowed this guy to get going at all in this period.
They get it back. There's the pass to Alvarado. For the three, James misses.
And the stroke definitely lacking confidence this quarter. Nothing on target.
And Jabari Smith, of course, with deep family ties, Greg, to the NBA.
His dad being the OG Jabari. All these guys are in that 6'10", 6'11 range. So great bloodline.
Here's Halliburton following the score by Jamal Murray. Here's Crowder. Smith trying to break loose. And the shot's good from Crowder. Crowder's got 7 points in the game.
I'll tell you this. Jay Crowder is one tough cookie. This guy won't be deterred by the defense.
Ayton against Towns. And it's Ayton missing.
Well, we didn't see the same kind of control we're used to seeing from him. This guy is usually a tremendous finisher.
Here's Halliburton. And he sinks that one in the back of the rim on the way in.
Well, because he's a three-level scorer, anywhere he is on the floor, Halliburton capable of creating jumpers.
And here's LeBron outside. It's through for a second basket. He's now 2 for 6.
Building up a big early lead. They have taken charge of this game.
And they've been doing it largely at the offensive end. If the defense does not adjust, this could be a blowout.
So, timeout. Charic comes in for Towns. And Hayes subbed in for Smith. Houston making a switch. Outside Crowder. Back to Halliburton. Now here's Hayes. Top and covering.
And now only one away from being
Jay
in the penalty.
Crowder. First personal foul. Second team foul.
Rockets leading by 11. Simons, the pass to Cabangeli. Here's LeBron, and James throws it down hard.
Assist goes to.
Okay, I guess LeBron wanted that one to sting a little. He put a little extra on that one.
And a look at the Mobile One Drive, driving right into your living room.
And that's a thing of beauty. Certain plays, almost no words. You just sit back and appreciate it. And on the glass so far, it hadn't even been close.
Controls the rebound and puts it back up and in.
And defensively, guys, they've been unable to shut down the middle.
And so it's Halliburton who brings up the ball for the Washington Wizards. Sharch finds Crowder. Halliburton with it. Back to Crowder. Pass to White. 6 to shoot. They need this. And James pulls it down. LeBron's got his fifth rebound in this one.
Wow, this defense is blanking him down the stretch, and that's certainly hurting his team's chances.
And they have owned the paint so far, and the score reflects it.
I know it's early, but you have got to like the dominance down low. Right now, they are playing bully basketball.
Now here's Crowder. He has seven. It drops for his third basket. He's missed only one shot. Houston leading by 15. James with a deep three. It's rebounded by Hayes.
And he's a good shooter from outside, but not sure from that deep.
Boy, we're seeing it more and more. Guys looking to create additional space by stepping back further from the line.
And it's White missing.
This guy has not been a factor at all in this quarter, and it has hurt the team.
Toppin dishes to Murray. Here's Simon. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
First,
that one on White.
No question he got mocked on that shot.
First trip to the free throw line for him in this one.
Anfernee Simons at the line.
The first one falls. Simons drops them both. And Doris, in a time where we see so much international conflict, Commissioner Adam Silver has said that shared loves and appreciations, including sport, can bring us all together. It's a nice thought.
It's a wonderful thought, Kevin, and I think immediately to the NBA Finals, where I see representatives from so many different countries, China, Brazil, and the opportunity to interact, to share our passion for the game of basketball. Listen, the hope is we can find more things that connect us than that pull us apart.
Looking at who's out there now for the Rockets. Brown is checked in for LeBron. And Vincent subbed in for Murray. They recover it. Rockets leading by 15. Now Simon. He's coming off a 10-point game against Charlotte.
Yeah, don't forget how great he was drawing contact and getting himself to the free throw line. Picked up a ton of easy points there.
Here's White. Hits it from three-point range.
A ragged start for him offensively, but he'll take it. It brings him to 1 of 8 from the field.
Over to the left wing. Vincent, the pass to Cabangeli.
And just tacks a few more points onto their lead with the tomahawk.
Ah, that's bringing it down hard. Washington's gone 1 of 5 from downtown in the first quarter. Points out there have been hard to come by. Pass to Crowder. Nice ball movement by Washington. And Hayes kicks to Crowder. Wizards need to get a shot off here. The shot's good from Hayes.
I mean, the number of points they've scored in the paint already here is eye-opening.
1:52 left in the first quarter of the game. Brown, the pass to Simons. Here's Vincent, White covering. Here's Cabangeli. Here's Vincent, lays it up off the glass.
Vincent.
And the Rockets lead by 14.
You know, it's got to be tough to win when you give the other team second and third opportunities to score the ball.
Back to Halliburton. Down low, White. And denied. He sends it right off the glass.
I'll tell you, you hate to pin this on one person, but his inefficiencies at the offensive end are holding this group back.
Pass to Vincent. From past the arc. That one's not going to go. And Washington the other way now. And the wide open shot from Crowder. That's no good, and he's 3 for 5.
And on an open look like that, he's very gifted at making the weak coverage pay.
Crowder against Simon. No good on the triple.
And the great shooters know when they've got enough opening to go for the three. I didn't think it was a bad choice on that possession.
Now here's White. 11 points for him in that last game against Miami.
Well, you also have to credit the way he controlled the pace of the game and was able to create for his teammates.
Brown outside. And the pass to Vincent. Here's Simons. And a double-digit lead on the scoreboard as we end the first quarter of play.
Your Wizards.
Rockets lead by 14. They'll be back shortly live from Washington. Has been one-sided so far. And guys, we've seen the Rockets really take control here.
What we saw in that first quarter, they won their matchups defensively.
I think across the board, a number of guys have done a great job guarding multiple positions.
Smith is out there with Jay Crowder. Then there's Towns. Then there's Tyrese Halliburton. And it's Dozier in at the two spot. That's the group starting the second quarter for the Wizards.
Well, look at the fluidity in the screen and roll. DeAndre Ayton so good at taking what he sees in these sets.
Back to Halliburton. Throws it up high.
And hard to decide which is better, the pass, the catch, or the slam.
Now, there's no wrong answer. Sensational alley-oop. Brown, the pass to Vincent. Simons against Halliburton. He can't hit that time. And it's Washington the other way. Second quarter, and we're just over a minute in. Passes it to Towns. Back to Halliburton. Over to the wing. Dozier. No good on the shot. A bit long that time.
The edge on the glass is the difference. It's allowed them to build this lead.
The offensive rebound. Simons, the pass to Vincent. A three ball. And they recover it to the inside. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line.
Third personal foul. First team foul.
The Rockets shooting their fourth and fifth attempts at the free throw line tonight.
Pratt taking two shots.
And that one misses. Well, we know the NBA has worked to get rid of the hard foul doors, and the league has done a great job of doing that. What has contributed, though, to that line of thinking?
Well, I think any play can be reviewed, Kevin, and that's a good thing, because if it's a non-basketball play, then you open yourself up to a flagrant two. The punishment is significant enough to discourage the action. I love the rule changes as it relates to this particular infraction.
Towns trying to get open. Shot by Crowder, no good. And here's Payton. He'll bring it up for the Houston Rockets. Only given up 2 points this quarter. Three-pointers, Simon. Houston gets it back. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
I'll tell you, this guy can be an overwhelming force. DeAndre Ayton, terrific, using his size to get the defender to commit.
The Rockets have shot 80% from the line tonight, going 4 of 5 so far.
Not really where you'd like to be as a team in terms of free throw shooting, just about 73%.
Bielitsa, he checks in for Washington. And the second free throw, good.
I think what you like most about DeAndre Ayton is probably how efficient he is on the offensive end. Now, obviously, the next step, he's got to raise his game and defensive intensity on that end of the floor.
Now, here's Halliburton. He's coming off a 10-point game against Miami. Shoots over Simon. And it's Halliburton missing.
They've shown some strength in the paint today. Their work on the board has been impressive. And just like you want to see assertive basketball.
He threw that one down, Greg, so hard you could feel the strength over here. Time called here. The Wizards decide to talk it over.
And the lack of rim protection, top of the list.
And the question they're going to have to answer to me is it a problem with the...
solution here.
Wizard, you dead thing. Let's make some noise.
Halliburton passes to Smith. Pass to Dozier. Just four to shoot. Now Halliburton. Offensive rebound. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and two shots coming up. It's going to go on Willie Cauley-Stein.
I love when Karl Anthony Towns is aggressive to score and willing to embrace the contact.
And Karl Anthony Towns said he believes that he is the greatest big man shooter of all time. What do you think?
Well, Kev, I think a guy by the name of Dirk Nowitzki might have a thing or two to say about it. But I love Karl Anthony Towns' attitude. You have got to believe in your skills if you're going to have the kind of success that Cat has had in this league. And we know he is lethal from deep.
And among NBA bigs, he is known for his ability to deliver at the free throw line.
LeBron kicks to Murray. Dishes it to Jackson. Terrific assist. A nice finish. Solid play all around.
Jamal Murray.
Superb agility from Jackson, rolling with purpose to the right places after setting those hard screens.
Now here is Smith. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. Over LeBron. Another shot. Towns, no luck.
And the way he was able to reach out towards that release had an impact.
Well, no question, he altered that shot. And most of the time, that's just as good as blocking it.
Jabari Smith.
The officials are all over that.
Second personal foul. Third team foul.
He's gone 1-of-1 in the game so far from the line.
LeBron
and high
James
quality numbers for him all season shots long. How about 81 from the line?
Free throw good, James.
I think, guys, the pursuit of greatness is what distinguishes LeBron James. Make no mistake, he wants to be considered the GOAT, the greatest of all time when it's all said and done.
And both free throws good for LeBron. Wizards trail by 20. Guys, they're looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively for sure.
Nice ball movement by Washington. Dozier passes to Bielitsa. Smith outside. Shot clock at 6. And another miss by Washington.
And I thought that was going to drop. It looked good from here.
Payton kicks to Murray. And he gets
Wizards
the whistle.
Down.
Two free throws coming up.
Anthony Towns.
And this system thrives on
foul.
Murray's aggression. Fourth when he attacks, back. You can just feel
two
the energy. And when he lays back,
Jamal
the offense
Murray
becomes stagnant.
The Rockets have gone 7-of-9 from the free throw line tonight. And he makes the first. And so Murray nails both of them. And so it's Halliburton who brings up the ball for Washington. He kicks it to Smith. Here's Dozier. They get the rebound. Here's Towns. Off target with the jump hook. Rockets leading by 22. It's LeBron with the drive.
LeBron
and
James.
Finished off by LeBron.
Yeah, they're rolling right now. That lead continues to grow.
And one of the things that's helped that is they're getting it done on both ends. Terrific focus on offense, and they're locked in defensively.
Smith finds Towns. Now, here is Halliburton. Shot to stop the run. Happy to see that one go in for a second make in 5 attempts.
Well, there's an unpredictability to his offensive game. He is always keeping the defense off balance.
Awesome display of athleticism captured by your AT&T 5G Slam Cam. No good from LeBron.
Well, they have the advantage, but you still feel like this guy needs to find a way to get himself going.
Smith the pass to Towns. Over Payton. And Towns gets it to go. Towns has got 6 points.
This is what you get when you combine size and touch. Karl Anthony Towns in the paint. That's good.
Here's LeBron. And foul
Wizards
on the
foul.
Shot. So he'll get a chance at the line.
Bielitsa. First personal foul.
This is his third trip to the free throw line.
At the line for the Rockets. LeBron James taking two shots.
Free throw drops for James. Whitey's checked in for the Wizards. So he gets them both.
And just doing a much better job of getting to the line this quarter than he did in the first.
Murray against Halliburton. It's taken away by Payton. Inside, Murray. It falls for the sixth time in seven tries this contest. That's 86%.
Yeah, they're going to have a nice little run here.
Back to Halliburton. Pass to Dozier. And here is Bielitsa. Five on the clock. Here's Halliburton. That's good for his third bucket. Now 3 for 6 from the field.
Tyrese Halliburton, that thin frame didn't matter a lick. Brushes off the contact. Love the grittiness there.
James, the pass to Jackson. And that one,
Josh
good.
Jackson.
Jackson's got his second bucket.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass.
Here's Dozier. He's covered by Murray. Smith kicks to Halliburton. Over James. And it's Halliburton missing. Houston's gone 0-3 from beyond the arc to start the second quarter. And it's Murray. That time on the assist by Payton. Murray's got 6 here in this quarter.
And inside, Murray's attacking mentality pays off. He just works hard to find his own shot.
Back to White. And the layup is good. White's got 5 now.
Well, use the pick and going right to the cup. I love the aggressiveness.
James dishes to Payton. And stolen by White. And there's the drive. And the rejection by James.
An engaged LeBron James on the defensive end is an absolute menace.
In the corner, Murray with it. Here's Jackson, and there's 2 points. Working on the glass, paying off that time. 6 points for him.
Well, a tough first quarter for this guy. You like to see the shot go in. Nicely done.
Here's Dozier. Back to White. Just 5 on the clock. Smith outside. Nail from three-point land. Smith's got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for 3. Murray against Halliburton. On the wing, Payton. Tried to come right back with a 3 of his own, but it's no good. Out to White from deep. No good. And Houston the other way now. Defeated by the Hornets in their last game, they'll try to put that one behind them.
I tell you, they were drawing a lot of iron from the perimeter. Couldn't get the threes to go down, and really the story of the game.
What was most disturbing to me was they didn't have a backup plan, right? The threes aren't falling. What do you do next?
So it's the Wizards now, after Jamal Murray was able to get that triple. The pass to Halliburton. A 3-pointer, no good.
2 minutes.
And here's Payton. He'll bring it up for the Houston Rockets. Murray finds Cauley Stein. And here's LeBron outside.
LeBron,
and again, it's the Rockets from deep.
A tireless worker, always looking for ways to improve. LeBron James has never looked more comfortable from 3.
Halliburton passes to Dozier. Back to Halliburton. Passes to Bielitsa. That ball, nice feed that time from Halliburton.
And guys, getting into a nice groove here, starting to feel it.
And this is partly what the game has become, right? A matter of dueling 3-point opportunities.
Jackson misses. The Wizards shooting a pretty low 34% thus far. Here's Smith. The teardrop falls in. Smith's got 5 points in the quarter.
And how about the floater from Smith, showing he's got some tricks up his sleeve.
James has a two-pointer. And he gets LeBron the friendly James. Spin, and that one drops.
Assist goes
and that's
two.
Now 19 points for LeBron.
Well, they're calling his number time and time again, and he is delivering.
Pass to Dozier. Poked loose and stolen by Payton. To the middle. And the dunk by Payton.
Barry Payton.
And you think Murray all about scoring, but Murray is about what helps his team win.
Washington shooting 38% in the second quarter. Offensively, they look a little bit confused. And they call an illegal screen here.
Well, that's two fouls on him early. He'll have to be careful not to pick up another one.
Let's take a second look at that fantastic block.
And a block like that sends a message. One that says we're not giving up this lead.
Washington making some changes. Sharch checked in for Bielitsa. Jackson Hayes comes in for Smith. And it's Crowder in for Halliburton. Pass to Ntilikina. Now, here's Simon. Guarded closely. Some solid defense from Sharich. Dozier passes to White. From outside the arc. And that one released in time, but
that's
no good. And so it's Houston in complete command. Their lead at 28 points going into the break. A look at the field goal percentage numbers tells the story of what tough defense they're playing today. We'll take a quick break and then back to the action here.
Tough outing in their last game. Kenny, what you think about the Rockets?
When you can generate second chance points the way they have, you should have the lead. It's been a massacre on the offensive glass. They're running multiple guys to the window, showing great effort and toughness.
After a very lopsided first half, we'll see if things play out a little more evenly here in the second. It's been one outstanding game from Jamal Murray.
And you know he's going to put up points every time out, but boy, he made it look so easy in that first half.
Now let's see if he continues that trend the rest of the way. He certainly has the talent and the endurance to do just that.
And as we dive into the second half, we'll find out if the next two quarters are any different from the first two. So far, it has been a runaway. Checking out the group for Steven Silas to start the second half. We've got DeAndre
Washington
and Bernie Simons out there with Ntilikina. And it's Alvarado in at the one. This is his first free throw of the game.
At the line for the Rockets, Biondu Papandeli. Two shots.
And he knocks down the first one. Second free throw, no good. Washington shooting poorly, just 35% so far. Here's Dozier. Goes up and lays it nice and easy. Dozier's got his second bucket of the game to go.
Well, Tyrese Halliburton has demonstrated terrific improvement running the offense, especially with how he moves the basketball.
That was a second look at our Mobile One drive. Amazing control on display.
And the awareness of his footwork and body on that
Washington
drive.
Foul. Wow. P.J. Dozier. Fourth
These are his
foul.
Third and fourth free throw attempts of the game.
Foul.
And really, guys, his percentage
at
from the line at
the Rockets,
70 isn't quite
DeAndre
up to snuff.
Ayton. Taking two shots.
Free throw drops for Ayton. Ayton hits them both. And so it's Halliburton who brings up the ball for the Wizards. Picked him clean. To the paint. Here's Ayton. The rebound by Halliburton. The jump hook. The Rockets pull it in. Greg, looking back at the 2021 draft, I'm still shocked Tyrese Halliburton fell to 12th. My goodness.
What a steal Halliburton has been. He broke his wrist in college. That scared some teams away, but boy, Tyrese has been awesome in the NBA.
White, back ball. Nice feed that time from Halliburton. Halliburton's got 5 assists in the game. The pass to Ntilikina. Simons with the ball. And it's thrown down hard with both hands.
Oh, boy, to be young again.
Makes you nostalgic, doesn't it? Wizards have gone 2 of 3 from the field to start the second half. Dozier kicks to White. Knocks it loose. Passes it to Dozier. And there's the foul. It'll go on Frank Ntilikina. That is his first foul of the game.
First team.
Yeah, that's a tough call right there, and really a tough break for the D.
Halliburton outside, looking to end his cold spell. That's good on the jump shot. Halliburton's got 8 points.
They're doing work here in the second half. 3 or 4 to start.
Simons finds it.
DeAndre. Well, the length and athleticism of DeAndre Ayton make that an easy opportunity.
Pass to Dozier. Now here's White. Smith with it. 5 points in the game. Here's Dozier. Off the mark there with the 3-point shot. White against Simon. To the inside. Here's Ayton. Rebound by Smith.
Houston foul.
Smith's got DeAndre 6 rebounds Ayton. Here tonight. And second there's the call on DeAndre Ayton.
Second team.
That'll
foul.
Be his second foul of the game. Washington's gone 1 of 2 from beyond the arc since coming out of the break. Shot from 12.
This guy just can't find his rhythm, and you look up at the scoreboard, they absolutely need his productivity.
Alvarado passes to Ntilikina. Ayton kicks to Ntilikina. Ayton inside, covered by Smith.
Washington
and
foul.
Contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
Second
that one is on town.
I'll tell you, for a center, the big man has got excellent touch at the free throw line.
Free throw drops for Ayton.
At the line for two.
Obi Toppin's checked in for Houston. Ayton hits them both. For Washington, they've gone 3 of 6 in the third quarter, 50% from the field.
Washington
time called here. Wizards decide to talk it over.
You know, my guess right now is Coach wants to talk over this turnover issue. And it seems like they've been trying to force things a bit and need to find a steady rhythm offensively.
Wizards dancer.
Bruce Brown comes in for Frank Ntilikina, and it's Jamal Murray in for Anfernee Simons. We've gone about 3.5 minutes into the third now. Nice ball movement by Washington. White against Murray. A three-pointer is right on target. Dozier's got 5 points now in the quarter.
Something's brewing, guys. The three-pointers just continue to flow.
Here's Alvarado. He's covered by Halliburton. They get it again. Here's Toppin. Here's Ayton. And that one goes long. And so it's Halliburton who brings up the ball for Washington. That one goes. Count it. Dozier's got 9 points.
I'll tell you, he's been much better in the second half. He's taking smarter shots. He's looking more comfortable. And guess what? He's in a groove.
Round the pass to Toppin. And Toppin throws it down.
Boy, Boy, the explosiveness of Obi Toppin can really shock the defense. This guy gets excellent airspace.
Outside, White. Pass to Smith. Halliburton outside. Five to shoot. The pass to Dozier. No good from outside. The Rockets shooting just 33% in the second half so far. They need to look at more high-quality shots.
Washington foul. Carl Anthony Towns. Third personal foul.
And guys, let's get your take on the scoring breakdown so far for the Rockets.
Shooting for Houston.
They've been running away from the defense all game.
Two shots.
I mean, loads of points here off the fast break. And the opposition just hasn't been able to adjust to that aggressive play style.
The other thing for this team today, they have a bunch of second chance points. They're turning misses into makes.
Bielita, he's checked in for Smith. He's perfect from the line this time.
Really getting after the defense since the break. He's so hard to keep off the line when he pushes the action.
Back to Halliburton. To the wing on the left. That's tipped. It's stolen by Brown. Kicks it to Murray. Back to Brown. Shoots the three. The rebound by Bielita. For Washington, they've gone 5 of 9 on field goal attempts since halftime. Not loose. Brown feeling it out a bit. Outside, White. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line.
First,
when you are
foul.
The aggressor, third being assertive, foul. Very often you're going to get the whistle, as Derek White did there.
The Wizards Derek shooting their seventh White. And eighth attempts at the two foul fouls. Line tonight. And that one falls for White. And so he makes both from the line.
I think the thing that's most striking about Derek White, guys, he's capable of affecting games in so many ways. Yes, he can score it. Excellent passer and a very versatile cross-positional defender. A guy who can contribute to a good team.
Six on the shot clock. And there's the call. It's going to be an illegal screen.
Yeah, but just the second turnover of the game. I mean, overall, pretty meticulous offensively.
Washington making some changes. Šarić has checked in for Bielica. And R.J. Barrett subbed in for Derek White. Washington's gone into the three-point range four times since halftime and buried two of them. And it's Halliburton missing.
Boy, in that close, he's almost automatic. But boy, that's pretty good defense. Wow.
LeBron dishes to Murray. Good work defensively by Crowder. They've been a little too casual with the ball out there.
Yeah, but you can't force that square peg into the round hole. Oftentimes, you just got to make that first simple pass and get a rhythm from that.
And a wide open look for Halliburton. Drills it from outside. Halliburton's got 11 points.
And they have been relentless from deep. And you see the defense trying to react, but to no avail.
Well, that's the whole point, isn't it? If you space the floor well enough, it's almost impossible for the defense to account for everyone.
This is his second trip to the line in this one.
Bruce Brown taking two shots.
First one falls for him. So for the Wizards, Dozier's checked in, and it's wide in for R.J. Barrett. And Brown drops them both. And so it's Halliburton who brings up the ball for Washington. Passes it to Dozier. Back to Halliburton. And White kicks to Halliburton. Pass to Dozier. From outside, off the mark. And for Houston, they're shooting with confidence, 50% from the field so far. James, and they call the foul, so he's got the and-one chance here to make it a three-point play.
Well, LeBron James shouldering the load offensively. He has done this from the time he entered the league.
And it'll be his fourth time going to the free throw line in the game. Wizards making a switch here. Wesley's checked in. Washington's gotten the three-pointer to fall to the tune of 50% here in the third quarter. They've made 3 of 6. Here's Dozier. He's covered by Brown. Driving to the basket. And plenty of contact on the shot. So, 2 free throws coming up.
First personal foul. Fourth team foul.
For Washington, they have been coming through at the charity store. They've made 7 of their 8 attempts.
Yeah, and over the course of the season, they're a respectable 78%. That comes in handy in close games.
So after making the first, he goes 1 for 2. And for Houston, they're shooting just 33% in the second half so far. They need to look at more high-quality shots. The Wizards have gotten 6 of their 12 shots to drop for him here in the second half so far. Pass to Wesley. White dishes to Sharich. Out left to the wing. Just 5 to shoot. Out to White. 3-pointer. It's rebounded by Houston. Murray, the pass to Brown. Here's Vincent, covered by Wesley. A nice shot by LeBron.
LeBron James.
LeBron's got 5 points now this quarter.
They're consistently finding ways to get the ball inside and taking full advantage.
And there's the pass to Dozier. Hayes in the post. Toppin's there. The shot's good from Hayes.
I'm not sure who was supposed to be on him that possession. I mean, apparently, neither did the defenders.
Here's Vincent, covered by Wesley. LeBron can't get it to go. For Washington, they've gotten half their shots to drop in the second half. Up to this point, going 7 of 14. And it's White missing. Houston's gotten blank from three-point land so far in the third. Still 0 for 3. Vincent, the pass to Murray. And some nice passing there by Houston. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot 2 free throws.
Second personal.
It's going to be on Sharich.
Well, the basketball IQ of LeBron James is off the charts. So adept at finding ways to get to the line.
He's gone 6 of 6 from the free throw line. That free throw missing, and Washington making a change here. Wara checked in. He hits the second from the line. Washington's gone 3 of 7 from three-point range here in quarter number 3. Plays it up and banks it in. Sharich has got his second basket.
Well, because of his size and length, Dario Saric so comfortable on the interior.
2 minutes remaining in the third quarter.
Vincent, the pass to Toppin. Back to Murray. Down low. And there's Toppin on the assist by Murray. Murray's got 4 assists in the game.
When you allow good scorers to get uncontested shots at the rim, no wonder you're losing.
To me, this is simply stated, been a complete lack of defensive attention and focus all night long.
And Hayes kicks to West, down to 5 on the shot clock. And the rebound goes to the Rockets. Toppin's got 9 rebounds in the game, getting it done.
Whacking James like the D does there is the right move. I mean, especially when you consider how strong he is.
He's been punishing them at the line, and this one going 7 of 8.
2 shots.
First free throw is good. The Rockets making a switch here. Payton's checked in. And James drills them both. And so it's Washington with it. 1:15 left to play here in the third. Wesley the pass to Dozier. Here's Nora. And here's Hayes. Toppin covering. They grab their own miss and foul on the shot. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line.
Second personal foul.
The defender all over it.
The Wizards have made their free throws at a pretty good clip. They've hit 8 of 10.
Washington. Jackson Hayes.
And the first one drops. The Rockets making a switch here. Hayes hits them both. Houston's gotten blank from three-point land so far in the third. Still 0 for 3. Vincent the pass to Brown. Passes it to Vincent. No one near Payton as he lets it go.
Rockets foul. Willie Cauley-Stein. Second personal foul. Fifth team foul.
Here's Weston. Pass to Hayes. Now Weston. Here's Norrell. It's rebounded by Houston. Kevin Kelly's got rebound number 5 here tonight. Pass to Vincent. Inside. A great 1-2 punch. Beautiful pass and nasty jam.
And the one-hand slam just looks so pretty when it's in his hand and he's the one doing the slam.
Agreed. He is smooth as silk, even on a power finish.
Listen, he can make that shot right there, but I do know they have other options they can go to.
And so it's LeBron James making things happen for Houston. A terrific quarter for him. And now he has a total of 27 points. Shouldn't take him long to get up over 30. And we'll be right back after this. And one quarter to go in a game that to this point has not been an evenly fought contest. Here's Wesley. They've got Bielitsa. He's out there with Jay Crowder. And it's Wesley in at point guard. That's the group on the floor right now for Washington. It's Crowder on the wing. Knocks down the three ball.
Well, so quick off the pass. I mean, Crowder timing that shot perfectly, staying one step ahead of the defense.
Neely Kina passes to Kevin Gill. Here's Vincent. And there's the whistle, the illegal screen.
Yeah, another turnover. The guys on the whole line doing a great job of running their offense without too many miscues.
Jackson, who's checked in for Houston.
And
Fernie Simons comes in for Vincent. Simons against Wesley. Cauley-Stein grabs the board. On offense, here are the Rockets. Payton finds Simons. Payton outside. He takes it in. And the rejection by Collins. Jackson gets the bucket.
They're doing a really good job of getting the ball inside and attacking the paint. That's an area they have completely dominated.
Now the pass to Norrell. Wesley against Simon. Shot clock at 5. Passes to Bielitsa. The Wizards with another miss.
And even with good coverage defensively that time, he has confidence to drill the 3.
Woo! How about the quickness of Josh Jackson off the drive to the cup? That is dynamite.
Washington's gone 1-2 from 3-point range here in the 4th. Pass to Wesley. Collins against Cauley-Stein. And stolen by Payton. And it's Houston on the break. And Jackson throws it down hard.
Well, this is tremendous athleticism from Josh Jackson. Boy, you better stay connected to his body or he's going to make you look silly.
Pass to Wesley. Doris, the NBA keeps talking about the idea of an in-season tournament, taking a cue, I guess, from European soccer. Do you like that? Do you think it would work?
Well, the European soccer situation has the advantage of tradition and history. There's meaning behind it. Obviously, I'm open to a little drama in the middle of the NBA season. The challenge is convincing the players and their representation in the Players Association that this is something of value.
Well, the grimace of pain tells it all. He's hurt, and let's hope he's okay.
And I'll tell you, this is something you never like to see.
No, obviously something that, you know, every player fears. The NBA has made player safety a priority, but injuries continue to happen.
The man has no heart, and that's poor defense for a team that has a long way to catch up.
Well, credit the offense, though. If you're going to come with casual defensive effort, this team's responsibility is to take advantage, and they do.
Really clearly fouled. Fourth personal foul. First team foul. At the line for the Wizards,
Tyrese Halliburton.
That's good from Halliburton.
I think if you're talking to Tyrese Halliburton, the thing that stands out is the wealth of things he can do on the offensive end. He can shoot the ball with range. He's got unbelievable handle. He can create. He can drive it. He can also set up his guys. A lot to like.
Houston
top, and he's checked in.
Houston.
You know what? Very close to a three-point play right there.
Second team foul. At the line.
And that one falls in college. We know the NBA is exploring alternate broadcasts for selected games, allowing users to pick their commentators. Doris, should you and I be nervous?
Kevin, I'm always nervous, and you will always be the A-team. Come on, my man. Fans know they need to listen to Kevin Harlan.
You are, Doris, way too kind. Coming from you, a Hall of Famer, you kidding me? I'll work with you any day, and I'll do the analyst, and you can do the play-by-play. How does that sound?
Kevin, love it.
Halliburton against Simon. Halliburton kicks to West. Back to Halliburton. Count it.
Tyrese Halliburton is putting in work right now. This guy getting to his spots and scoring with ease.
Halliburton against Simon. And stolen by Bielitsa. Here's Wesley. And two free throws coming up. Unable to get that one to go with all the contact.
Third personal foul. Third team foul. At the line for Washington.
The first free throw is good.
Taking two shots.
And he can't hit the second. Rockets have gone an outstanding 4-5 from the field in the fourth quarter so far. And he gets
Washington
the whistle.
Foul.
Two free throws coming up.
I tell you what, he earned his money
first
on that foul.
Personal foul.
In recent
first
years, Doris, foul. We've really seen the Players Association stepping up and
Gary
address
Payton
player needs and, at the same
taking
time, global social issues.
Kevin, it's been absolutely inspiring to see the players use the tools they have at their advantage and their disposal. They want to create needed change, represent themselves, their communities, their organizations. Leadership at its absolute finest.
And the whistle blows as the basket counts, and a three-point play chance right here. One free throw coming up.
Well, I think you have to appreciate how Jay Crowder sees the floor. This guy is an unselfish player who wants to get his teammates involved.
And for Houston, they're shooting it really well. 54% from the floor. Simons against Halliburton. Pauly stop. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
First person.
And what I like about Cauley Stein is just how hard he plays. Really, both ends. A scrappy player.
Pauly Stein at the line for two.
Good on the second free throw. Washington's gone 1-2 from three-point range here in the fourth. Halliburton passes to West. Here's Crowder. Makes that one, his sixth of the night. Shooting very healthy, 6-for-9.
You've got to be careful if you give Crowder a little bit of comfort, because the guy starts to make a couple, and then he's really dangerous.
Nice job capturing the moments on the AT&T 5G Slam Cam. Here's Payton. Offensive rebound. Jackson kicks to Simons. Payton dishes to Jackson. Clock at 4. Toppin. The Rockets again can't hit. And so it's Crowder with it. He'll bring it up for Washington. Halliburton passes to Crowder. Bielitsa against Payton. And so it looks like Washington will retain possession here.
Gets a finger on it, but just can't quite come up with the steal.
But a really good read on his part, being disruptive at the defensive end right now.
The Rockets making a switch here. Kevin Gelly's checked in. Rocket 6. Oh, went in there and tried to power it down. But Drew Konjac, who had to the line. Last year, as we know, the NBA, Doris, named the members of the 75th anniversary team. Any players that were missed that you think should have been on that list?
I mean, the one guy that comes to mind immediately is Klay Thompson, who will go down as one of the great shooters in NBA history. The problem for voters, I think, is the challenge of weighing the accomplishments of prior generations with what we are witnessing today. It is a challenging vote. There's no doubt Klay will be top 100 when he comes in 25 years.
Vincent's checked in for Peyton. The Rockets have gone 4 of 8 in this fourth quarter, shooting an even 50% from the field. And the call will be against Anfernee Simons. That is his first foul of the game.
Personal foul.
Yeah, really good defensive play to cut him off there and square up.
The Rockets making a switch here. Alvarado's checked in. Outside Crowder. Good for another basket. He's put up 10 shots and made 7 of them.
Boy, this guy has been terrific. The rest of the team, however, struggling.
Here's Alvarado. He's covered by Halliburton. Vincent the pass to Cabangeli. Ball's knocked loose. Crowder with the steal. A pass to West. Back to Crowder. Halliburton inside the three-point line. And the shot is long.
Not sure what the D was doing there. Clearly a breakdown. You can ill afford to give a guy like him that good a look.
Vincent the pass to Jackson. And Jackson throws it down hard.
And really a good job spotting his teammate near the bucket and then just pinpoint passing for the finish.
Passes it to Wesson. Bielitsa with it, guarded by Jackson. Pass to Wesley for three. No good on the shot, so Houston will take it the other way. To the middle, here's Cabangeli. That one misses. Collins with some nice D. For Washington, they've gone 6 of 12 from the field here in the fourth, and even 50%. The elite to misses. For Houston, they've gone 5 of 10, 50% from the field. Pass to Vincent. Here's Alvarado. And we all know that injuries are a part of the game, Doris, but it seems like for taller players, bigger players, there can be an additional challenge. Why is that?
Well, think about it, Kevin. If you're a 7-footer who maybe goes between 250 and 280 pounds, playing an 82-game grind with so little time for rest and for healing, the modern game with all the movement that's required, that is particularly challenging for any big man of that size.
Houston's gone 1-3 from outside the arc since we've reached the fourth quarter. Here's Vincent. To the paint. Here's Jackson. Good once again. That makes him 8-for-9 this game.
And this is encouraging to see from Josh Jackson, proving he's got takeover ability. That's pretty.
Halliburton passes to Crowder. Now, here is Halliburton. He's tightly guarded. And here's Crowder. 5 on the clock. Rebounded by Jackson. Jackson's got 7 rebounds in the game. There's the pass to Toppin. Here's Cabangeli. He's guarded by Collins. And the officials will call the illegal screen right there.
Beyond the leaning, you can see his feet more set on that screen. Easy call.
You know, he's just leaning a little bit. You try to get away with it, but boy, the official all over it.
Brown, he's checked in for the Rockets. Here's Washington. They're on a 16-7 run. Halliburton passes to Towns. Three-pointer, Crowder. Vincent with the rebound. Vincent's got his 4th rebound with that last one here tonight.
I'll tell you, this has not been his game, and he's making it worse with shot selection like that.
Round the pass to Vincent. Here's Cabangeli. Hey, Crowder pulls it in. And so it's Crowder with it. He'll bring it up for the Wizards. And it's White missing. Halliburton against Brown. Pass to Vincent. Isn't it great? The NBA is becoming a global product. More games are scheduled overseas. Yours, any locations you'd like to go to call a game? Maybe you and I could do a game in the Bahamas. How does that sound?
I love it, Kevin. If they're tipping it up, I'd love to be there. And think about it, beyond the travel and the opportunity to see the world, the opportunity to expose new fans to this game that we love so much, certainly not something to take lightly. Well, easy money, right? I like the strategy. Go inside, get a high percentage look.
Outside, White. Here's Towns. Misses, and the dry spell continues. Houston's gotten just one of four three-pointers to go down for them here on the fourth. And it's out of bounds. The Wizards will take it the other way. Peyton, he's checked in for Toppin.
Substitution on the court.
Now Wesley. Outside Collins. At the elbow, it's Šarić. White, left side, uses the glass to finish the layup.
Yes, and with this one winding down, it's obvious to everyone who watched it. Just a total mismatch and a true show of strength for Houston.
You don't see this kind of a blowout often, but tonight, this is a quality win across the board to deliver out this kind of punishment.
They definitely never changed the approach. They just kept after it and showed they were clearly the better team in just about every single category.
And reaching an impressive milestone on the year, this will be win number 60. And guys, they have played so well this season. I think pretty much any given night, they've come in with that swagger and attitude, and they've really backed it up.
A two-game season series, they win them both and complete the sweep.
And what a tremendous standout performance it was for LeBron.
What you love about his performance is that he is simply taking what the defense allows and then making the most of his opportunities.
Rockets substitution. Willie Cauley-Stein. Jamal Murray.
...23 seconds left to play here in the fourth. Outside, White. Pass to Wesley. Here's Norah. And again, Washington, no good. Here's Vincent. From deep. Can't connect. So we see Houston taking the W here. A resounding victory for them. And Greg, in enemy territory, no less.
That's exactly right. But with the way they controlled the game and just completely took the crowd out of it, that's how to get it done on the road.
And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Thanks very much. Jamal, you really got after it tonight, and obviously the game means a lot to you. How do you find that edge?
I just play better when I have that motion. And we were very physical, aggressive from early on. We handle hits and handle the streaks and runs all game. So today was just a bounce back game, and we look forward to continue this.
Well, you kept your head and it led to a win. Congrats. Back to you.
David, thank you as always. That's it, folks. The NBA regular season is in the books. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and David Aldridge, and the rest of our terrific crew, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. We'll see you later.